Hi everyone. Today I want to share a unique experience I had during a recent meditation. For a few fleeting seconds, I saw a vision of a dark blue indigo being. This vision was unlike anything I've experienced in over my 25 years of meditation. In the past, during my meditations, I would usually see a pool of blue light. It is in an oval shape. The edges of this oval shape, they are not even and constantly move like energies. This time round, instead of that pool of blue light, this blue person just appeared. I was surprised by this vision of the blue person. This being, as I later discovered, is known as Neela Purusha. I hope I pronounce it correctly, or the blue person. It happened just a few nights ago, after I closed my eyes for meditation. Then I saw this being. He suddenly appeared with curly hair and blue indigo energies flowing all around him. And he too was blue and indigo energy. Or rather, should I say, he was, you know, made of his whole body, his clothes, everything was blue indigo color. He looked directly at me with a peaceful demeanor. I was surprised by this vision. I wondered who this blue indigo being was. What was the meaning of this vision? Was there a message for me? I had so many questions that filled my mind. Then I remembered a book I had read decades ago. It's called Play of Consciousness by Swami Muktananda. I went to my library of books and found the one I was looking for. As I flipped through the pages, a chapter titled The Vision of the Blue Person caught my eye. Swami Muktananda's book is a spiritual autobiography that details his journey to self-realization. In that chapter about the blue person, he shares his own experience with Neela Purusha. As I read his words, I found many parallels with my own experience. I would like to share some extracts from this chapter and reflect on them in comparison to my own experience. I do encourage you to read the book for full understanding. For decades, I have seen the blue pearl or blue light when I meditated. It was egg-shaped, as described in the book. During this meditation, my experience was as if the blue pearl or light was less visible. At once, the blue person was seen. It was like, you know, as if my third eye vision zoomed into the blue pearl and I saw the blue person. I have yet to realize that the blue person was a mass of consciousness, as the book says. The real form of Nityananda, or the playful divine Kundalini. But I did notice energies glowing all around him. He was indeed resplendent. I have to agree with Swami Muktananda. The blue person's body is beautiful. He did have beautiful eyes and features. And so true. I didn't see any beard. There was no beard. One thing, though, I did not see was a crown on his head. Maybe it was there, but I did not notice it. I was looking more at his curly hair that seemed to move like energies. Indeed, everything about the blue person was blue, or, you know, indigo in color. His face, his hair, his body, and even his clothes. And I agree again with Swami Muktananda. The clothes, oh my goodness, the clothes he wore, they looked so fine, so soft and fine. And though I did not see his body below the waist area, the parts I saw was truly exquisitely beautiful. It has been many years since I read The Play of Consciousness. More than 25 years. As I reread this chapter, I learned that the blue person is called the Neela Purusha. Again, I apologize if I mispronounced it. Swami Muktananda further explained in the book that the blue person is the supreme unmanifest being by whose blessing one proceeds to the realization of the ultimate truth. I am sure I've been blessed by the blue person. After all, seeing him is a blessing, right? As for the realization of the ultimate truth, let's just say that I have been having insights. I do pray for more information and guidance. While I did not see the blue being returned to the blue pearl, my meditation did end rather quickly. I pray for a longer session with the blue person in the near future and to have a meaningful and enlightening conversation with him. From both my experience and Swami Muktananda's teachings, I learned about the potential meanings of seeing the blue person during meditation. These insights helped me understand the significance of my vision. As I read further into this chapter of the book, Play of Consciousness by Swami Muktananda, I see that the blue person had been described in the Gita too. If you'd like to learn more, you know, you can refer to the Gita. His teachings were fascinating to me. I wondered, what are the three attributes of manifestation? And how is it possible to be free from them and yet enjoy them? I know I have more to learn from the blue person. When I first read Play of Consciousness, I enjoyed Swami Muktananda's teachings and was fascinated by his spiritual experiences. During the time I read the book, I had already been seeing the blue light, also known as the blue pearl. I never expected to see the blue person, and it has taken me more than 25 years to see him, and I am so grateful. As Swami Muktananda taught, the blue person is everywhere. He is also within you. Keep meditating, and I hope, like me, you will see the blue person one day. One thing for sure I have learned, he is indeed within the blue pearl. What I have also learned is that to see the blue person, you need to practice meditation. I practice flowing love meditation regularly, and it helped me to see the blue person. When one encounters the blue person in their meditation, it can be a deeply personal and spiritual experience. It's important to reflect on the vision and interpret it in a way that resonates with your own spiritual journey. To enhance your meditation experience and possibly increase chances of spiritual encounters like the blue person, I recommend trying Enora binaural beats. In conclusion, my encounter with Neela Purusha, the blue person, has been a profound and enlightening experience. It has deepened my understanding of my spiritual journey and enriched my meditation practice. I encourage you, my dear friends, to remain open to such experiences and explore their meanings in your own unique way. And if you're interested in enhancing your meditation experience, try flowing love meditation and give Enora binaural beats a try too. I'd love to hear about your experiences. Until next time, stay curious and keep meditating. I wish you good health, wealth, and love.